Something unique about bees is that they are a society, but they are also fundamentally a single organism. When you look inside a beehive, there are tens of thousands of bees rolling around on those frames, caring for young, collecting nectar, making honey. But it's fundamentally one organism because it's only the queen that lays the eggs. The queen is steering the ship, and if you lose the queen, you lose the entire hive. So bees are what we would call a super organism, right? That it is many individuals all sort of following simple rules and pulling towards a single goal to create something bigger than the single organism. In this course, students learn about the basic biology of bees, as well as how to care for hives in both a commercial and residential sense.
Being there at a hive in person for the first time and seeing the lid popped off, and there's just bees everywhere. It can be summed up to a, oh wow, kind of experience.
Here at Fresno State, we are in the heart of the San Joaquin Valley, which is the most productive agricultural valley in the United States. Here in the plant science department, we are very focused on making the valley grow. Honeybees are an increasingly important part of that agriculture because many of the crops we produce here either require honeybees to set fruit, such as our almonds, our squash, pumpkins, our stone fruits, or they have higher yields, or they only produce seed when you pollinate them.
Bees are so much more complicated than anyone would ever think. You do get a sense of respect when you get up close and personal with bees, because everyone knows the phrase, busy as a bee, but you don't think about it until you really look into the hive.
It's a course where I get to focus on the positive aspect of insects in the world. In the plant science department, so much of my work is focused on managing pestiferous insects, so we're talking a lot about insects that are damaging crops, insects that are being controlled with pesticides. It's really nice to say, hey, there's a lot of insects in the world that are doing tremendous good. Let's focus on one of those species and what we can do to help it. Honeybees, as we know, are really a struggling species right now. They're facing tremendous pressure from migratory beekeeping practices, from varroa mites, from diseases. And the more biologists, the more chemists, the more engineers we have looking at these problems, I think the more likely we are to get solutions.
The value in being able to see an actual hive and put together the pieces of what you've learned in class in a real life scenario was just top tier. It was phenomenal.
It's really the hands-on aspect of the class that is the spark, right? That gets these students really interested. It's one thing to sit in a lecture and hear, oh, you know, it takes 21 days to progress through this particular life cycle, or this is what a queen looks like, but it's a whole other thing to see the queen crawling on the frame and see all of her attendants gathered around her and, you know, touching her with her antenna, trying to figure out what she wants. Because that gets the students excited. And it makes them start to realize, oh, this is something I could do.
Honey as the end product, instead of just going to the store and buying a jar of honey, it's different. Knowing that you've put in the love and the effort into something makes that reward so much sweeter. I really enjoy that agriculture and plant science are so important to everyone. I enjoy that interconnectedness and being part of something that helps not just a select group of people, but everyone. This class has brought in that final puzzle piece, which has brought together this entire well-rounded and whole experience of what agriculture is, especially here in California.